Hey, I'm John with EAW, and I'd like to introduce you to our new KF810. It's a dual 10 cabinet. It's a three-way bi-amp cabinet, so the mids and highs are passive. We can look here at the actual take apart of it. Some interesting technology we've kind of upgraded. We've created a new waveguide for it. So the waveguide, obviously, we know is to get as clean of a front flat wave as we can out of it, right? So this waveguide takes into account everything from here to every point along here being exactly isophasic, which is great. I don't know if you can see in there very well, but it's basically a little airplane wing looking thing in there. So there's very minimum drag to any of the HF moving through there, not like some of the older designs where it had to kind of bounce through different length paths. It's a very smooth thing, so it's a very, very silky high end that's got a great, like I said, isophasic wavefront, so it's going to fly far. We are putting a 3-inch coil with a 1.4-inch exit driver on it. We're excited about that. That's a lot of power in a small space. The next thing that we've got going on here is there's four mid-range drivers behind it. We're using what we call our constant summation apertures. Those are the little diamonds here. There's a rule in acoustics that basically says that if the HF going across a surface sees an 80% solid surface, it thinks it's a solid surface. So we basically are minimizing any distortion possible out of the mid-range affecting the high frequencies. The size of the diamonds look kind of small. Yeah, well, that's because we're not doing a whole lot with the mids, and they're setting up the correct frequency to come through that size of a hole. Okay, that allows it basically to ask as like a high pass for the highs, low pass for the lows, so it creates the correct impedance inside of the horn. Okay, the next thing we've got going here is instead of, if you remember our 730s, 740s, we did a lot of side firing transducers. We kind of went away from that with this. Well, why would we do that? Well, we do a lot of research and we listen to our speakers and such. We wanted it to be small and compact, so adding a driver like 740 would have made it larger, heavier, more expensive, but that's what we do, so maybe we should consider it. So we went through all of that, and then we came up with this. Basically what we've done here is we're shifting the apparent acoustic center, and because the engineers were able to kind of play with that, the drivers are where they need to be physically in the box for matching the cabinet volume, but the acoustic center has been moved out to here. And we were able to slide that acoustic center with this so we could actually take our polar, our horizontal coverage, and manipulate it in such a way that the side firing driver really was only a few percent better or worse. I don't remember which way it was actually. But it was so close, we're kind of like, well, why would we make it cost more and have more weight and more components and be harder to service when we can do that like this? So this is our next evolution in what you would expect in class leading EAW sound quality and pattern control. Everything is here, no compromises. So if we'll take a walk around the back, I'll just show you one of the nice features of this one. This is our install box that's gonna come out first. Everything on the box was thought about to be as architecturally transparent as possible. We wanted it to be able to go up in the shadows and disappear. No extra shiny hardware on it. Everything's blacked out, including we did panels for it. So if you maybe take a look at the white one hanging here, you can see it a little bit better. Like from the ground, it's gonna just look really pretty. All the cabling gets hidden inside of it, everything, the hardware. There's really no angles for light to catch funny things on. Once you run the wires down through in between the boxes, if let's say that this was upside down, of course, maybe the sub is above it, you would bring your wiring harness into here, feed it up through there, come up through here, and basically every bit of wire is visually hidden. So again, the kind of our buzzword we've been saying is architecturally transparent. It becomes as clean as it can look. The next neat piece, I'm not showing it here, but the subwoofer actually ships with a grill for the front and back. Why would we do that? Well, what if we wanted to flip a sub around for cardioid? So now it looks the same from the front and the back. I just have it off here so that I could show you the cable chase. So in a nutshell, that's our box. Like I said, this is the install one. It'll be the same wooden box, same components, everything like that. We'll change out the hardware for captive hardware that slides and hides for the touring market when we get ready to do that hardware, which will be the next thing you see from us. So great, thanks.